15th December to 29 January 2014. So many things can happen.
All this time, your members, some of them you said, were perishing.
I'm telling you. It's a pathetic... You know, I want TV3 to take this as a challenge. Go to Ashaiman. I can tell you, if you see 10 mentally deranged people who have maybe lost their way in Ashaiman walking, 9 of them may be former workers of Ghana Port and Harbors Authority. I'm telling you this as a fact.
I see.
So many people have been ejected from their rooms because, you know, they are strangers. Luckily, I'm a guy. And that's what has kept me this way. You understand? But so many of them, they are out. Now,
did you get the ruling you wanted eventually?
No.
It didn't happen?
No. Listen to the Chief Justice. I beg you. And listen carefully to the Chief Justice. In her last submissions, one of them, let me quote from you. In the circumstances, in as much as the writ of summons in this case was issued on May 2008, well over the 12 months limitation period under Section 92 of the Port and Harbors Authority Act, the appellant action was statute barred. She also used the PNDC Law 160. The Court of Appeal, therefore, did not fall into any error when it so decided. Painfully, this appeal has to be dismissed, and same is hereby dismissed. I say painfully because it is not that appellant did not have a good case to pursue, but they have lost because their case was not handled with due diligence. In the case of Fodjo versus Law Chambers and Co., the court held that in undertaking their client's business, legal practitioners guarantee existing and due employment skill and diligence on their part. Quoting, now, in the present case, why did counsel fail to amend the writ of summons in accordance with the order of the court after he had been granted leave to do so in the case of 365 plaintiffs he sought to adu after the Agbesi case when he issued the writ on behalf of the appellant's hearing? Was he not mindful of the limitation period under the act of which reason he should have resorted to negotiations rather than court action?
Okay.
This is the Chief Justice asking.
Okay.
And lastly, she said, regrettably, the Chief Justice, regrettably, the appellant who have been treated so unfairly by the respondent authority live here without applied, rather worsened.
Okay, so the Chief Justice acknowledged that the issue, your grievance.
You are the Chief Justice of the Republic of Ghana, and I was a beneficiary of his free lecture, and I'm talking about Dr. Akwaji in 1987. What he said, it was, he told us that in general legal practice, and I want any lawyer to, contest this. He said in general legal practice, you cannot hold the fault of a counsel against his client.
His client. So when it happened, the workers petitioned, you left the court and petitioned other state institutions.
Oh, yes. Seriously, I have taken it on myself again to petition the President of the Republic. Last year and this year, I have petitioned Parliament, the Speaker, the two leaders, the Minister of Interior, and the Chief of Staff at the Flagstaff
House. What's their response?
Nothing.
You are yet to hear from
nothing.
Them.
And we are dying. And we are talking about corruption. President Mama have already said that corruption is a mass murder phenomenon. Now, President Kufuor also said, corruption is as old as Adam, and it can be proven by the Bible. Go and read 1 Samuel 12. Ghanaians, I'm calling on you to read 1 Samuel 12. Corruption did not start today. It's an old lion that devours mankind. My brother, we have done everything that we could, but still, As it has been said, just wait. The right moment may come. Because I would say that I'm even happy. about this case, because if it has not dragged this way, I won't find my way to the World Bank. Because the World Bank, I was with Ishak Diwan, the former World Bank country director. And he told me that what I'm talking about is savagery.
So you still have hope that this will be resolved?
Seriously, no. I'm giving this case to TV3. Let's follow it up. Because the World Bank paid to the last dollar.
Everything to the company.
There was no local content.
And yet you suspect management decided to shortchange
how much. Yes, and we are talking about somebody here. Let me show you his face. That's him. His name is called Ben Owusu Mensah. That's him. This is the man who committed all these crimes. And he started committing these crimes, not today. This paper I'm holding, this is Port News. We call it Port News. Every year we get it. This is him. He was a consultant. And right, it will amaze you to know that that this man had a consultancy called Benom, B-E-N-O-M, Ben consultancy. And it was this man who did the consultancy work for this particular exercise. And the document is here, referring. It's serious, my brother. The document referred to the plight of the 1989. And I'm telling you, in that case, it's my uncle, Atako. My uncle, the only survivor man standing today in that case. Mr. Don, I'm talking about is the one who led them to court.
Let's move.